You guys ready? We might have to start because we don't have plenty of time. How many of you guys saw the one that's called Charlie in the Chocolate Factory? Huh? Only a couple of people saw that movie. There's been several kinds of variations of it. That was the closest one to the ending of Johnny, because Charlie had a very, very poor family, and his household was tilted, right? Did you guys know that part? And there was like a hole on the side, and he had like himself, mom and dad, the grandma, grandpa, and the second grandma and the second grandpa. Did you guys know that? And one of the grandpa, he decided to hide like $2 under his pillows. And apparently that $2 was hidden under the pillow for 7 years. 7 years. And when the time came that Willy Wonka was going to sell tons of chocolates, and only five of the chocolates was going to have like the golden ticket. Did you guys remember that? And there's like four kids that got the golden ticket, and including Charlie. Charlie got the golden ticket too. But when he went to his grandpa and he says, "Grandpa, did you hear that the chocolate with the golden tickets have been released?" And the grandpa's like, "Come here, Mr. Charlie." And it's like, "Yeah, what? Come with me." And they went next to his pillow, and he said, "See this $2?" And he pulled out the $2 from under the pillow and said, "I've been hiding this $2 for 7 years." "What?" "And you're going to take this $2, you're going to run down to the chocolate store, and you're going to buy us two chocolate bars. And I really, really hope we win the golden tickets, because whoever brings a golden ticket to the golden ticket factory or the chocolate factory, Mr. Willy Wonka is supposed to let you in and give you like a big tour of his whole huge, 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 tremendous, I mean, huge chocolate factory." And guys, guess what? In case you didn't saw that movie yet, even the walls on the inside of the building,
accessibility shortcuts, 8 items, voice guide off,
of chocolates and all kinds of candies. And some parts of the wall, if you saw a picture of a banana, and if you lick the banana, guess what? That part of the wall tastes like banana. And if you go to the part that looks like cherry, and if you look the cherry wall, guess what that wall tasted like? It tasted like cherries. Yeah. And guys, guess what? Three things I gotta tell you. Number one, I think that Charlie won the ticket because he was a good kid. The other bad kids, the other four kids, they were not very nice. One of them was naughty, and the other one was just like lazy, and there were so many not nice things that the other kids do, right? And that was the whole reason, because Willy Wonka wanted to figure out which one of those kids was a nice kid, and eventually he gave his whole chocolate factory to the nicest kid, which happened to be Charlie in that movie. Right. Did you guys know that? You saw that movie, right? Didn't you?
Yeah.
It's called Willy Wonka. So Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. That's what it's called. If you haven't seen it, it's called Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. Okay. Check it out. It's a really good movie. The newest version is my favorite one. But anyway, if we're ending the Johnny story, then I probably have already told you that they were just like Charlie. very poor. His house was tilted to the side, holes in it, leaks, comes back down from the ceiling, goes into the bedroom, right? And in Charlie's case, when he went to go get the chocolate, he was so excited. He ran so fast. And he fell down because his leg tripped on something. And one of the chocolate broke. And he was like, no! But then he saw something shiny in the wrapper of the chocolate. So, ooh, let me check, let me check, let me see what it is. Oh, it looks like a golden color. Looks like a golden color. And then it wasn't. And it's like, no! He really, really wanted to have the golden ticket because they've been poor all his life. They've been poor. So he ran up to Grandpa and said, Grandpa, here's your chocolate. And Grandpa's like, Charlie, where's yours? It's like, I'm sorry. I fell down and I broke one of them. And so I opened it up and it didn't have the golden ticket. In that case, this chocolate is going to have the golden ticket. And Charlie's like, how do you know? Is that even possible? It's like, yeah, I just know because you are one of the nicest kid in this whole town. And things are good, happens to good people. Really, Grandpa? I don't think so, Grandpa. I really don't think so. Oh, yeah? Watch this. And he opens it and he says, oh, I saw something shiny. And Charles is like, yeah, Grandpa, mine was shiny too. And it happened to not be the golden ticket. But look, Charlie, it's really, really, really shiny. Like, I know, Grandpa. Mine was really, really, really shiny too. And he goes, check this out. It's the golden ticket. He's like, what? The golden ticket? And he started jumping up. This old man has not been out of that bed for 7 years. He jumped out of that bed. He goes, bring me my cane. Bring me my hat. They started dancing, and they danced their way down to the chocolate factory. And guys, guess what?
What?
He did something bad. He almost did not win the chocolate factory. Okay, Charlie has set up the whole building to see if which one of them was gonna not do something bad. Okay, now I might have to tell you guys this. Sometimes it's like so easy to do something bad, right? And it's like, oh, I don't care. I'll just do it, and then I'll go back to being a good kid, right? But sometimes even if you make just one mistake. One mistake, it could hurt a whole bunch of every tomorrows. A whole bunch, sometimes years. Do you guys know what I'm talking about? And since you guys are already good kids, keep it that way and don't, like, if something is very tempting that is bad to do, just be like, I'm not that kind of person. I ain't gonna do it. Okay? Do you guys understand? And okay, so the three bullies that were really, really bad and they were really mean to Mr. Johnny, guess what? That was the reason why that old man found Johnny's dad, who was supposed to be his best friend, and they were very, very poor, but he was like, Dad was like, Johnny, look, here's the key to that brand new house, and it's now our house. And the house was huge. Did I tell you what was in the house yet?
Nope.
I didn't tell you what was in the house yet? Okay.
Nope.
I'm going to tell you at least three parts of it. Okay? And if we run out of time, then I'll tell you the rest later. Check this out. When he was running to the house like, Dad, you gotta be kidding me. Is it really our house now? And Dad's like, okay, if you don't believe me, then take the keys and try. If it opens the door, then you know I'm telling you the truth. If it didn't open the door, then I've given you the biggest prank in your whole entire life. So Johnny was running, and I've seen some of you guys where you run and you land on your knees and you go, and while he was sliding on his knees, like, Lord, please let it be true. I'm really, really, really tired of being so poor. And he went up to the doorknob and was like, oh, please. He said, fell down on his knees again. Please, Lord, please let it be true. Is it going to work? Is it going to fit? Oh, it fits. Is it going to turn? Is the key going to turn? Let me see. And turn. What about the door? Is it going to open? Is it? And the door opened. And when it did, he was like, no way, this is happening. This is unreal. He started jumping. I was like, yes, doing, doing, all over the house. Dad, did you see the kitchen? Because the kitchen was huge. The kitchen is probably the size of two or three of the whole house that I live in. That's how big it was. And it's like, I wonder what the living room is going to be like. And he looked into the living room. Oh, it was like combining the two dojos together plus another dojo. That's how big. And he was like, Dad, did you see? And Dad was drinking his coffee. And I was like, yeah, I saw. Oh, Dad, what about the bedroom? What about the bedroom? Well, do you want to see the bedroom first or the game room first? You're like, oh, there's a game room. But which bedroom can I have? And he goes, you can have whichever bedroom you want. What? Are you serious? As a matter of fact, how about you go over there and look at least three or four bedrooms just for yourself? No way. This can't be happening. Dad, are you serious? So he ran upstairs to go look at his bedroom. And on his way up is when he saw a little bit of the game room. And guys, I promised you guys three of the rooms. Okay. That was the kitchen. Right. That was the living room. And then that was the bedroom. So we might have to save the game room, which is perhaps my favoriteest of all my favoriteties. Sensei Chinibi, how much time do we have?
It is 12:17.
Oh, I'm so sorry, you guys, but guys, as far as that game room, you won't be disappointed. Okay. Even Oscar and Betty, was it? And Dolly and all the other dogs won't be disappointed. Except I think Oscar's like, oh, I'm just going to take a nap.
No, I'm telling Oscar.
These are good. Oh, there's also a monster story coming up, okay? If you guys like monster stories, don't forget to tell me at the beginning of next story time. Okay?
Okay.
And you guys are too fast of eaters because, well, I can't really say that because I finished my carrot before some of you guys. Anyway, enjoy your days and your rest of the afternoon, and so if you saw something very tempted to do that's bad, just don't do it.
Yeah.
Hi, Oscar.
Thank you, Shihan.
Bye, Shihan.
Bye, guys.
Bye, Shihan.
Bye.
Bye, Shihan.
Bye.